guys, it's your girl Ava Loving It, and welcome to another travel vlog, Philippine travel vlog. I'm currently here at Batangas Port. I took a bus from Buendia to here. It's about an hour and a half, and I paid for 167 pesos for an air-conditioned bus. There's also a bus from Cubao, so it's up to you if you guys are close from Cubao or Buendia. Yes, magroro ako today. This is actually how I used to travel before. And the last time I did the roro, it was like a year and a half ago or 2 years ago. It's been quite a while and I missed it, and I decided to do it again because I have nothing else to do. I wanna explore more of the Philippines. My departure time was moved from 9 to 11 p.m. So I have like 4 to 5 hours of waiting, but I don't mind. One of my travel blogger friends, Gabs, is also joining me in Romblon, but he's only gonna be there for about 3 days, and then I'm on my own for the rest of God knows when. I'm going back to Manila, but as of now, I'm excited and let's go. I've been waiting for about 2.5 hours. Luckily, I have a viewer who saw my Instagram story and invited me for dinner, so I'm not alone. Say hi to Ali. Hi, Ali. And she treated me dinner. Thank you for the dinner. Yes. Hi, shout out to your sister.
Hi, ate.
Her sister also watches my vlog. So, hello, sister. Anong name niya?
Mara.
Mara. Hi, Mara. Wish you were here. Time check. It's currently 10:30 in the evening. Finally, we are about to board. I had to pay 30 pesos for the terminal fee and wait in line. The boys and girls are separated. They're gonna check our bags here. Make sure that we are far away from our bags. Kasi may mga sniffing dogs, mom sniffing dogs. Made it here at Ojongan Romblon, and look who I'm with. Gabs and Eric, and this is Ian. He's a local from Ojongan and he's going to help us around Ojongan. Yeah, tablas, tablas. We're about to eat breakfast. If you guys are wondering how much is the ferry, it cost us 1,591. Wow, sobrang exact for a cabin bed, bunk bed. There are also different types of bunk beds or areas. There's a tourist area and also a standard area. Both of them are much cheaper, but we are fortunate enough to get a cabin room. So it's more private, especially that we have a lot of gadgets and it has its own bathroom. Ayan. It took us 7 hours from Batangas to Ojongan. As soon as we arrived the port, we took a tricycle, paid 50 pesos each. Okay, I'm gonna eat now. I'll see you guys in a bit. So now we are about to ride the Habal Habal. We rented them for 700 pesos full day na. Yan, with the driver, because it's better to have a driver. They know the way. We don't. Nina kailangan mag-waste. He's gonna join us only to Look. That's a good thing about joining the locals here. They know where to go, who to contact for the Habal-Habal and everything. So, ngayon, sunod-sunuran lang kami. Ako, sunod-sunuran din ako sa itinerary niya. Siya talaga yung nagawa ng itinerary. Alrighty, ang pangalan mo, kuya?
Ronald.
Hello, I'm Abe. It's your girl. Go subscribe to my YouTube channel. Plugging agad eh. I like everything about you. You guys, Hubadera is back. I am at my happiest. whenever I'm in a bikini and at the beach. We are here at Look Fish Sanctuary. We paid 100 pesos each for the entrance fee and the environmental fee. However, we are only allowed to stay here for 2 hours, so we're gonna make the most out of it. Ready to conquer that water. Oh my gosh, I'm a jump too. There are no restaurants here. Buti na lang, I brought water and food, so basic necessities. I am so happy that they have a lot of gadgets, especially the drone. Well, I brought my drone with me, but it's always nicer if I have someone with me that can fly the drone, and then I'll just steal the clips from them. So whatever you see here, it's all because of them. The rental fee for a snorkeling set is 60 pesos. Well, it's a fishing sanctuary, so most likely there will be a lot of fish. There's a lot of fishes in the sea, yet I still can't find one. Ano na, mga besh, ha? Where na you? Dito na mi. Tagal mo. Later, we are here at Barangay Poblacion's Palengke. Ate, saging po. Ayan, magkano yung isang ano? Kailangan ko ng diet. So, sabi ng doctor, I eat too much and I drink too much. I don't know about drinking. Thank you po. Made it fam here at Aglikay Beach. After 30 minutes of bumpy ride, the boys are setting up the drone to get... Oh, there you go. Drone shot.
Oh my gosh.
But, oh my gosh. We have the place all to ourselves, like what the heck. There is a hill over there that we can trek, but it is currently 1:30 in the afternoon. I'm not sure if it's advisable for my skin, you know. Gosh, 1 hour of a balabal ride. My butt hurts, but it's worth it. We are here at Binokot Beach. The sand is not as fine, but look at this. Ganda. I ordered a melon shake. And it's 80 pesos. What more can I ask for? Amazing view. Amazing girl. Charat.
20 minutes later.
It's so beautiful. Look at the colors. Whoa. So blessed how beautiful this country is. I can talk to the locals easily because I speak the language. And it's also a good thing for tourists because Filipinos can speak English like 95%. Can understand, 95% can speak English, even if sometimes our grammar is incorrect like me, but at least you can understand me, and that's all that matters, right? Communication. As Filipinos, we have been crazily blessed with these kind of natural wonders. It's just here for you guys to see. Like, you just have to go out of your house and explore. There's always an excitement of seeing different beautiful spots, not just the usual ones, not just the ones that we see in photos and videos. I don't know, I'm just really appreciative. You don't get to see a beautiful sunset as this every day. You got to let it go.
Early the next
next morning,
safely arrived here at San Agustin Port just in time for the 6 a.m. ferry boat ride to Romblon Island. It wasn't funny at all going here. It was intense because there's a lot of sharp roads. It was not well lit. People are starting to board and I am vlogging and people are just, you know, staring at me as usual. Anyway, we rented the tricycle for 1,200 pesos. Wait, hold up. I know it's expensive since we are in a time pressure because of those two. Instead of waiting 5 more hours for the 7 a.m. jeepney ride, I think it's 160 pesos to 180 pesos per person. Thank God we're here and I'm excited to explore Romblon Island, more beaches, because 3 beaches from yesterday wasn't enough. Let's go.
One step is all it takes to get us moving anywhere.
After a 40-minute boat ride from San Agustin Port, we made it here at Cobrador Island. Look how clear and blue the water is. And the good thing is that we are the only ones here. That's the best thing about traveling during weekdays. For our first stop, we are here on an island for cliff jumping. We rented this boat and it cost us 2,000 pesos to rent the whole day. Also, if you come here, please make sure to bring food with you because we actually didn't bring any food. And bring water. Okay, because there's not much stores here. I think that's the best thing about this island. It's not as commercialized. Pinoy travel freak taking photos. And this is Eric doing his job. Photographer slash videographer all in one. Look how amazing this water is. Crystal clear. Blue sky. Green mountains. What else can I ask for? Mama Nature. Ganda. The wind is quite strong and our boatman doesn't want to pick us up when we dive from here, so we have to swim all the way there. It's quite far and I'm not really a good swimmer. I know how to swim but I'm not a pro. Gusto ko talagang mag-swimming. Here's the view. At the cliff jump area around Cobrador Island. So for now, Eric and Gabs are at the barangay hall to pay for the environmental fee, which is 20 pesos per person. Does the locals even realize how beautiful their place is? Like, what the freaking heck? Look how clear it is. Only the locals are here swimming. Imagine this is your own natural private swimming pool. You don't have to go to a 5-star resort or hotel just to have this experience. Every time someone asks me what is my favorite country, I always say the Philippines. It's 7,107 islands. There's a lot of islands to explore. You just have to go out there and explore it, see for yourself. I think that's me being a proud travel vlogger from the Philippines and showing foreigners how beautiful our country is. I'm so proud of it. Of our island hopping tour, we're here finally, the much awaited Bonbon Beach. Are you gonna shake your bonbon now? Shake it, bonbon, shake it, bonbon, shake it, bonbon, shake it, bonbon. We literally waited to get here just to sing that. Charat. My gosh, it reminds me of Maldives. What's up? Look how nice it is. Later, it's gonna be more beautiful. especially when it's low tide. Now it's starting to die down a little.
Just then.
So we were out there taking drone shots and all of a sudden, pluk! His drone crashed. I think kaya pa to. This can be saved. Hindi naman ano yung gimbal eh. Let's put rice. And about to eat late lunch. Yes, cheers. Bon appetit. Good morning, Romblon. Day 3. I'm back in a ferry. It'll take us 2 hours from Romblon Island to Sibuyan Island. It's been raining pretty hard since this morning. Hopefully it'll stop as soon as we get to Sibuyan Island. So that's the update. I'll see you guys in a bit. We're finally moving. I am currently editing the Romblon vlog for you guys. The fee from Romblon to Sibuyan Island is 190 per person. And if you're a student, it's 162 pesos. Made it here at Magdiwang, about to ride this jeepney. There's no more space inside, so we have no choice but to sit on top of the jeepney. I just do hope it won't rain, please. Bonbons are hurting. Shake your bonbons. That's a shake talaga siya. Because it's rough, bro. But look at the view. Yes. It's also nice because it's not as sunny. We're gonna be like this for another hour and a half. It's 200 pesos per person. If you're not our type, cowboys, cowgirls, maybe you should just rent a van instead. Or bring a car. We made it here safely at San Fernando after 2 hours of being on top of that jeepney. It was a fun experience. We dropped off our stuff in our hotel and now we are here in a small carinderia or eatery in English. Get some food to eat. We are starving. We didn't get to eat proper breakfast. There are no restaurants in Cresta de Gallo. Just gonna buy it from here and make sure to bring lots of water with you. Always, always drink lots of water, especially during summertime. I cannot stress enough how important it is for your body. Okay. A long day and a long journey, we finally made it here at Cresta de Gallo. But before I show you the view, I just want to say that these are our two boatmen, si Ramel and si Mark, and they're setting up a hammock for us. They are boatmen and we rented them for 2,500 pesos for the whole day now. But unfortunately, since we got here late, we only have an hour and a half or 2 hours here and take advantage of the island. We are the only tourists! Look at this view! Thank you. This is our last full day with Pinoy Travel Freak and Eric. Make sure to subscribe. Give him a like on his Facebook page. I'm gonna link everything below at the description box. Follow Eric Travel Journal on Instagram for more travel photos. Comment below if you guys want to see more of Pinoy Travel Freak and Eric the Explorer and Ava Loving It Adventures. There were a bunch of locals here earlier, but they already left. We have the place all to ourselves. We don't have to pay for anything, just a pump boat. Bear in mind that if you guys, whenever you visit an island, or not an island, a city or a place, always, always please dispose your trash properly. I've seen some trash around. I picked it up and threw it in a proper waste bin, and then I'm gonna return it to Sibuyan Island. They think that it's okay to throw trash anywhere because someone will pick it up for them. No. Please be a responsible traveler. You don't want to see such a beautiful place like this being trashed. Imagine what happened to Boracay. That's Mama Nature calling your attention to please save her. I think I'm also responsible for letting you guys know about this problem. Maybe some of you guys aren't aware of it. Sometimes the place is so beautiful in pictures, but if you see trash, please pick it up. Good morning, everyone. Ramadan day 4, still with Gabs and Eric. They're going back to Manila, and I am heading to Carabao Island. Left San Fernando around 4:30 a.m. and we arrived at around 7. We need to go here early at Magdiwang Port because some of the ferry schedules are inconsistent. Sometimes it's earlier, sometimes it's late. I paid 300 pesos to San Agustin and they paid 700 pesos to Lucena. As you can see, there's a lot of people lined up. It's because the bunk beds are first come, first serve. It's gonna be a race. And that's the gate. It's so small. Our jeepney ride from San Fernando to Magdiwang Port is 200 pesos, just like yesterday.
A few moments later.
It's currently 7:50 in the morning, but we still need to wait for 40 more minutes until we can get to board the ferry. Medyo mainit sana, hindi jumutot sa kuya. Walang buutot. Travel pa more. Ginusto namin to. Panindigan na. Cute nyo naman. Twinning pa yung cup nyo. Eto na guys. This is it. The moment of truth.
Sana yan?
We are about to rage. Let's go. Begin doing. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay guys, meet and greet time. Meet and greet.
Hi, hi, sir.
I am not a mandirigma. Almost there. Oh! Ang sakit, parang pag-ibig siya. Oh my gosh! Freedom! Ginusto ko to, di ba? Traveling on a budget. This is how it is. The real life, if you wanna always travel. Of course. Budget travel is the way to go. But these are the consequences that you should take. Where are my friends? They want to. They're still inside. So now I need to hurry up so that we can save up bunk beds. First come, first serve. There are no reservations. Paunahan to, guys. It's a race. Thank you. Okay, there are no more bunk beds. It's because some of the people cheated. They don't know how to fall in line. So they went inside using a tricycle.
Where's the taas na lang?
Hindi aircon dun. Ito na. Aircon sa harap? Taas? Hindi ah. Dito tayo sa likod, okay na to. Para may maupuan. Aga one base, ganun. A lot of us had to fall in line just to get here for 40 minutes. No, more than 40 minutes. And still, we don't have a chance. But anyway, thank God, we're here. Good morning everyone, Romblon Day 5. I made it here at San Jose or Carabao Island. So yesterday I didn't get to vlog that much. It's because I arrived at 4:30 p.m. I was like, I was so tired from yesterday's trip. So I decided to just relax and enjoy this amazing view. What the heck? I am the only tourist here right now. Today we are going to tour around the island via Habal Habal ride, and I'm gonna rent one out for 500 pesos for the whole day. They said that it's easy to go around the island. It's better to hire a Habal Habal ride instead of a boat. So yesterday I arrived from San Agustin Port, and as soon as I got there, they said there are no jeepneys. I had no choice but to hire a Habal Habal for 600 pesos to Santa Fe, and it took me about an hour and a half. The view from San Agustin to Santa Fe was amazing. The scenery, the coastlines are amazing. Next thing you know, I'll be on a rice field. Next thing you know, I'll be in a jungle. When you look to your left, it's the beach. When you look to your right, it's the mountains. Like, all in one. This country is really blessed with everything. You can see everything here, from waterfalls, beautiful beaches, beautiful mountains, beautiful rice fields, and the people are so friendly and they're really helpful. That's the best thing that I enjoy whenever I travel the Philippines. As soon as I arrive at Santa Fe, there's a banca that was waiting for me, and it cost me 1,200 pesos. I know it's expensive, but it's because I missed the last trip from Santa Fe to Carabao Island, which is 2:30. I arrived in San Agustin at 2 p.m. So to get here from Santa Fe to Carabao Island, there are boat schedules, regular boat schedules, from 9 a.m. That's the first trip, and the second trip is at 2 p.m. If you want to go from Cateclan to Carabao Island, it's also 9 a.m. and 2 p.m. boat schedules to and from. So that's a regular daily boat schedules to here. Look at this view. It's just me. Wow, wow, wow. So for accommodations, it's not as crowded here, so you can easily walk in other hotels and just ask the locals. Everything here, they know how to speak in English. So if you're a foreigner, you're good. You're good. Hiya! Do you remember him from our first day in Romblon? He's also here in Carabao Island. Now, he's gonna help me out to around Carabao Island. Yeah. Yes. This is Kuya Erwin, and he's gonna be my driver, my Habal Habal driver, to tour around Carabao Island. Let's go, Kuya. About 5 to 10 minutes, it is a bumpy ride, so I highly advise to get a proper Habal Habal, especially a tour guide. Kuya Erwin is a tour guide, so quite fortunate with that. We made it here at Angas Cliff Diving Point and Cave, although it's quite unfortunate that we can't go inside the cave because it's much better. There are no way from here to get to the cave, so you have to rent a boat to see the cave. But here it is. This is the diving point. it's 30 feet and that one is 20 feet. To get to the cave, we need to trek a little. Yan. Mas maganda talaga pag pinahihirapan, guys. Good thing that we have a tour guide who knows the way, because there are no signs at all and there are no developed roads. So it's not advisable for you to go here alone, on your own. Ito talaga ng tubig. Oh. We made it! That's the cave. And there's another small one. Oh my gosh! Wow! Ang ganda! Grabe! Nusa Penida who? Char! Wow! For our third stop, we are here at Miriton Cave. Ang galing mag-drive ng habal-habal. I'm gonna put his number below, so if you guys wanna go here to Carabao Island, you can contact him. Although, it's advisable. One person per habal-habal para mas safe kasi the roads are bumpy and it's uncomfortable if there are two people at a habal-habal ride. So, ayan. The trek would take us 5 minutes. Depende kung gaano kami kabilis.
Kasi siguro may umuwi dati dito na malalaking tao ba?
Ay. Kuya, huwag mo kong takot yan.
Hindi naman.
Meron silang paduhat, guys. I've never tried this. Careful because it stains daw.
Magdila.
Ang ahim! So it should be soft daw, guys. Ashim nang nakuha ko.
That's your friend.
It's so sour. Sa letrang B. Bingo. This is what they did. Inalog-alog nila yan with the salt. Now it should be sweet, hopefully. Ayoko na. Duhat is not for me.
Maganda yung kukunin mo yung durog na.
Yung durog na. Yung ganitong durog. Parang puso ko durog. Oh, wow. Okay na. We even have buko. It's included with the entrance fee, which is 100 pesos per person. One of the popular spots here in Carabao Island is the Cathedral Cave and Cliff. As you can see, there's more people around. But it's still not bad. I think it's only one boat. Ayan, so... Hindi, okay lang po, marunong ako lumangay. Thank you po! The jump-off point is 20 feet. And mag-swimming. Woo! The entrance fee is 100 pesos per person. Grabe! For our last stop, we are here at the Kuding Kuding Cliff Jump and Cave. And paid also 100 pesos for the entrance fee and environmental fee. Trip. I'm back here in Poblacion. I think this spot has the best beach all throughout Carabao Island because it is almost similar to Boracay Sand. I hope you like this video. Comment below which part of this vlog is your favorite. If you guys want to see more of the budget-friendly backpacking Philippines vlogs, comment below. And if you do like this video, please give it a big thumbs up, share it to your friends, to your family, and yeah, I'll see you guys on the next travel vlog. Bye guys, love you all.